Do it.
Guys, Jensen and Jared are about to take the stage. But they're not going to do that until you guys show them the energy you've been showing us all weekend long, Toronto.
Thanks for the chair. I'm really excited to... Do I just hold a perma slot?
Oh. Yes.
There you go. There you go.
Aww.
Well, I'm going to make this official.
Make it official.
Toronto! A big Canadian welcome to Mr. Jensen Ackles and Jared Padalecki. Look at him, boys.
Guys and gals. I'm sorry. Y'all didn't understand that. Hello, A. I did the A, A.
Bonjour, A.
Know your audience, Jared. Know your audience.
Dang it.
How you doing, big fella?
Good, brother. How are you?
Yeah, pretty good. I'm a little stuffed.
A little stuffed?
Yeah. I ate Rob's lunch and my lunch.
Is that why you unbuttoned everything?
I did, yeah.
Including your pants?
I gotta let it breathe a little bit. My stomach.
I hope.
I got a full cackle from one up here on the front.
A full what?
Cackle.
Cackle. Got it. The Ackles cackle. The Ackles cackles.
I'll give you a little, I'll take care of you.
Oh, come on!
She knows what I mean.
Yeah.
Everybody enjoy the weekend? Won't you ask your question?
How many first-timers in the audience? Nobody?
Like first convention, Supernatural convention?
Seriously?
You're lying.
What have you been?
Is it just because you just got into the show, or is it just because you don't like this?
She said I wasn't born.
You weren't born. Got it.
They've been saving money this whole time. They've only saved up.
Just got in. Yet. Just got into the show.
Been saving for 15 years.
That's right. It's expensive.
What'd you say about Africa?
She's from South Africa. She has an excuse. The rest of you, we've been coming to Toronto every year. What's your excuse?
I'm from Norway!
Okay, not every year.
Did she bless
know what I'm
race?
Trying to say, not actually what I said. First
Did
off, happy Thanksgiving,
race?
Canadian.
Exactly.
Thank you for spending it with us.
And sorry for spending it with us.
Sorry.
Do you guys do the like the turkey and stuff today? Is that today or is that tomorrow? It's tomorrow. It's today? Y'all need to figure that out.
Can we
some do it today, some do it tomorrow.
Can we come over? Who is the best turkey?
Yeah, I don't care about that. Who's got the best pie? I'm gonna kind of lob that one up there. She's throwing me softballs here. All right, well, we can pretty much sit here and annoy you all day, but we're gonna get to some of your questions.
Continue.
It's just continue annoyance. Hi, how are you?
Hi, I'm so nervous. I'm Shania.
That's a weird name.
Shania?
So nervous, it's nice to meet you. This is Jensen.
It is a weird name. It's very long.
So nervous. It's German.
It's a very long name.
It's so nervous.
So nervous. That's France.
Richard was talking earlier about his experience directing you. So I was wondering what it's like from your side to be directed by...
Do we have time to unpack that?
Do we sell him out, or do we sing his praises?
I mean...
Sell him out.
Spate is a very, very, very talented actor, a very, very, very intelligent person, a very, very, very talented director.
Where is this going?
He's not super fast.
Digging deep.
Did you say that's what he said, or that's what she said? I don't want to know.
It wasn't me. It wasn't you.
We have a... Did it get posted? Did the picture get posted on Instagram or something? The tape we had put on his trailer door?
Yeah.
Yes.
So the funniest thing I've ever done is name him... Spate Team Takes. Because we're like, Spate, dude, been doing this for a while. And so we're like, Spate Team Takes, Spate.
I had a thought, now I forgot it. Dang it.
Crystal meth is a hell of a drug.
Yeah. Thanks. She's like, crystal meth is a hell of a drug. Oh, I know what it was. So yes, he does like to pursue and cover his butt
too much
in regards to like the editing process. So a lot of times, directors that kind of come at it from an editing standpoint, they'll shoot a lot of stuff, and even some stuff that they may not need. But it's really, it gives them more material to play with, more toys to play with when they get into the editing booth. Spate had a page and a half scene to shoot.
Tell me about it.
A page and a half, right?
So if you you were to
so how much of that? How much would that be on film?
So it's like a 40-page. If it's basically a page per minute.
So it's about a minute and a half.
42 pages per script. Yeah. So a minute and a half.
So a page and a half is roughly about 90, like 90 seconds.
Yeah. 3 hours of filming. Yeah.
And about 3 hours of filming. But the actual what it takes, how many minutes you are recording. So you've got, you know, you would have Jared's coverage, maybe a couple of takes of that. Then you would move in, do a close up, a couple more takes of that. Then you turn around, you do.
Wait, are you directing me?
No, I'm not going to direct you.
Oh, never mind.
A minute and a half is all we needed. Space shot 90 minutes on that one scene. 90 minutes
of coverage
of film.
Of film.
Yeah. It took
it
us
6 hours?
Oh, like 6-7 hours. And I'm like, what is happening?
Yeah. He loves directing.
I think he loves editing more because he's giving himself a, you know, so much. But anyway, look, I love the guy. He's a dear, dear friend, part of the family.
And a very talented.
Very proud of him. He does really good work.
But hurry up, Spade.
But hurry up, man.
Hurry up, wherever you are. Jeez.
So we're working on him. We're working on him. We've got him for a couple more episodes, and you know, it's a learning process, and we also just have to beat it out of him. Jared's getting really good at that. As soon as he walks on set, like the first, like without even blocking, he's like, "Well, we're already behind schedule. Yep. All right, here we go, Spade. How many angles do we need? Do we not need this time that we're gonna shoot?"
My specialty.
And then this is Spade's reaction every time. Okay. Okay. Okay.
It's like he's rounding her.
That's him dealing with Jared. It's good to have him on board. He's doing all right. We'll keep him in line.
Thank you.
All
right. Hi, my name is Selena. I just want to thank you, both of you and the entire Supernatural family, for the little journey you've taken us on for the past 15 years. And to keep fighting with the odds against you.
Say it again, I'm sorry.
Pardon?
I got it, I'm translating.
Okay. My question is for both of you, if you could be in a TV show or a movie with any actor or actress or cartoon character, what would it be in Ninja Turtles?
He's doing.
Ninja Turtles don't count.
No, they count.
They count. If I could do anything or could have been a part of anything other than Supernatural or Gilmore, I suppose. Thanks. Thanks, Mom. I would have loved to have been on Simpsons.
Does it have to be cartoon?
You
is
still
that what,
can.
Just, whatever, what other cartoon would we want to be a part of? Is that what you're saying?
It's still on.
Part of a cartoon.
You can still be on it.
Thundercats. Thundercats.
What would you like to see us on?
Half the audience is like, what is that?
They can suck it.
Even
I know what that is.
I don't know anything.
Oh, come on now. You can't ask the question and not have an answer. What do you want to see Jared Padalecki and Jensen Ackles on?
Rodney Dangerfield.
Charlie's Angel.
I think she said Charlie Daniels.
Jack. Yeah, just say like.
What'd she say?
I don't know.
I'm gonna forget I didn't hear
that,
that, whatever you are. Thank you. I'm gonna stop. What? I'm gonna stop.
Hey, this way.
Yeah.
Hi.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Marley. I'm 14 years old and I'm just starting high school. I was wondering if you could give me any advice on the boys that I'm meeting.
They are all awful. So between Jensen and me, we have three young, beautiful daughters. None as old and beautiful as you are yet. But I would say, just stay away. Because high school boys are very strange and can't control themselves and are a little rambunctious. So be you. What's your name, Haley?
Marley.
Awesome. Marley, focus on what makes you happy. What's your favorite subject? Are you in art or drama or singing or?
I really like math.
Woohoo! Oh my God! Yeah.
Fuck yeah!
I love you back.
Hey, Marley.
Hey, two against
find
one.
You know what? Here's a little advice. The popular boys, they're probably peaking right now. So go for the math nerd in the corner. Be friends with him. Because they tend to peak for the rest of their lives.
Thank you.
Mathlene Unite. Marley, you're my girl. All right? You're my girl. Thanks, Ruby. Have fun.
What's funny is when you said you were like, what's your favorite subject? And you only named like art electives. Yeah. And I was like, what if she like science or math? And she's like, math. I was like, nailed it.
I just feel a kindred connection.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi. My name's Lisa.
Hi.
First of all, I was hoping that maybe you could just say hi to my daughter Macy because she didn't get picked to ask a question.
Hi, Macy. Macy or Macy?
Macy.
Hi, Macy.
Where's Macy?
Hi, honey.
Stand up. Where are you?
She's right there.
Where?
I'm holding the red phone.
Who are you pointing at?
Right there.
Hi, Macy. How are you?
All right, now sit down. What's your question?
Hi. I was just wondering if you could maybe share with us one of your favorite childhood memories of your life.
You got one?
I got a bunch. Okay, so when I was maybe around 10, my family took a road trip to Florida, to Orlando, to go to Disney World. Orlando. And I have always been a bit of a strange guy. And no. As a kid, as a kid, I was pretty strange.
As a kid,
that was too easy.
That was beautiful.
Strange is beautiful. I love you, whoever you are.
That's right, Marley. Look for the strange ones. Not too strange, though.
Because
that gets weird.
This was, you know, almost 30 years ago, long before the days of pagers or cell phones or GPS tracking or anything. And I've always been a wanderer. I just kind of walk off. And I walked off. And couldn't find my papa, my mom's dad, who was there with us. I couldn't find my brother, who was, I think, you know, 11 or 12 at the time. And there was no way to get a hold of them, so I was like, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get on the monorail. So I may have been 8 years old. And for those of you who know 8-year-olds, that's not a good feeling to lose an 8-year-old, I'm sure. And so I lived like la 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 la. riding the monorail, going to like Epcot Center and Universal Studios. And then finally, this is first thing in the morning, by the way, when the gates opened. And finally, I'm like, oh, the parks are closing down. I'm gonna go back to Disney World and see if I can find my family. And Disney World was really easy, so I went back. I couldn't find them, so I just left. Where did you go?
Did you
grab a cab?
Uber didn't Texas? Exist.
So I was like, well, Crystal I couldn't find him in Disney drug. World. The fireworks were over. So I started walking out, and my pawpaw was waiting by the exit, crying. He had been crying all day. And he thought I had been kidnapped, so he was waiting by the exit to see if somebody tried to walk out with me. And I was like, pawpaw, hey! And he's bereft, you know? He's a grandfather who thinks he... Because I think my mom and my Mimi, my grandma, had gone to, like, I don't know, we're supposed to meet him up or something. And so he felt responsible. He thought I'd been kidnapped. And so he had just been waiting at the entrance. Yeah. So I don't know if that's a funny story, but I'm alive. I'm alive.
This is tragic.
How old are your kids? I don't want to talk about it. I've like injected them with GPS tracking devices. So I'm good. I know me and I know how they, I know half of their blood. So I'm on them. I can track them right now.
I'll give you a quick one. I was playing... My brother and I were in the not the front yard, but the side yard where we grew up.
How many yards did you have?
It was like a shared yard between the house next to us and but that's where we always would play.
Did you hear about the two houses that fell in love?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
They had a long distance relationship. My bad.
Norton.
That was nope. Great.
Tell mine.
Anywho, my brother and I were playing some game that was like, it was like soccer, but not, we kind of made up our own rules, made up our own games and stuff. But there was this one little tree in the center of this yard, and he kicked the ball, and it went past me, and it was going to go into the goal, and he was going to score, but it bounced off this tree. And so, stupidly, I ran up, and I was, you know, maybe like 8 or 9 or something like that. I ran up, and I hugged the tree. And I was like, oh, thank you. And I pulled my hand out, and there were 4 yellow jackets sitting on my hand. And I looked at them, and it was like time slowed, and I think they all 4 looked up at me and just went, and they stung me, all 4 of them, on each of a finger.
They hurt bad. They hurt bad.
And I was like, ah! And so I went running to the front door, to our house, to run in and grab my mom, and I was hurt. And my dad had just installed, so there was a front door, but then there's, like, you know those glass doors? It's like a screen door, but it's glass. So the door was open, but the glass screen door that was just installed was not open. Wham! Laid me out. And the entire time, my brother's going, ha, 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 ha.
Hey, took your mind off the yellow jacket.
Sure did.
Thank you.
Good times.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
My name's Amanda, and unlike you guys, I have only been to 4 cons in my life. Toronto, Montreal, Toronto.
Why do you hate America? Don't answer.
You guys, what question are you surprised you still haven't heard?
So wait, I missed that. What?
What question are you surprised you still have not heard?
Apparently that one. I can tell you a question I'm surprised I haven't heard this weekend. And that is, what's up with Jake Abel being on set? Because that's been a question we've gotten a lot for a long time, is whatever happened to Adam? And obviously that might be getting dealt with. Misha already told you.
Finally.
I mean, what's up with that guy?
Yeah, I agree.
So, anyway, that's one quick, but I don't know, is there, we've been asked a lot of questions over the last 14 and a half years, if not by fans, then by reporters, and if not by reporters and fans, then friends and family. I mean, I still get the weekly report call from my parents after they've watched the episode. And then I realized, I was like, oh yeah, I guess we started back up, because Thursday night I got a call.
Hey, did y'all hear, speaking of funny texts from parents, did Spade tell you about the text that his dad and mom sent?
No.
No.
So Richard texts me, I don't know, yesterday or 2 days ago or 3 days ago, and it's like, and he takes a screen capture of his cell phone, and it's like, Dad, Spade, hey, did you get a tattoo? And Spade's like, no? Why are you asking? Well, we just saw something on the interwebs or whatever. That it was a picture of you and Jensen and the guy from Walking Dead. And Richard was like, Dad, that's not me. That's Jared Padalecki. So then his mom said,
no, it was his mom that said it. It was like, no, Richard. Your dad is actually referring to Jared. He thinks Jared is you.
So then Spate sends something like, yes, it's amazing. So then Spate sends back to his mom and dad, like, do you not remember what I look like? And he's screen capturing this and sending it to me laughing. And I was like, oh, dude, you gotta send them pictures of me and be like, Dad, I'm still the same guy. And so I send you a picture of, like, Sam Winchester on TV Guide.
Was there a picture of, like, you and Frank, or you and Steve?
No. It was, so I sent him a picture first of...
Jared, stop it. I think it's Morton.
Don't risk it. So I sent Spate a picture. I sent Spate a picture of me on the cover of TV Guide, and I was like, dude, you gotta write, Dad, I was just on the cover of TV Guide. Surely you remember what I look like. And so he sent that. And then I had a picture of me and Shep from ACL or something. And I was like, Dad, this is me with Fletch. Surely you at least remember him, right? And so he's sending these pictures of me and my kids and his parents. And his mom is like, you're being mean. You're being mean to Dad.
You're your father.
Stop it.
I just love that it's the text message between all three of them. And it's like Spade is dad, Spade is dad, 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 Spade, dad, mom. So she only chimes in when it's absolutely necessary.
She's the moderator. Also, 3 or 4 years ago, when Frank, one of his kids, was at a con in the green room, they were on the way home, and he's like, hey, Frank, this is Richard. Frank, you have a good time? He's like, yeah. He's like, what'd you like? He's like, well, I like throwing the football with that guy that looks like you. I won't lie. And Spade's like,
what?
The guy that looks like me.
Rob?
Yeah. He's like, what do you mean the guy that looks like me? And Frank's like, you know, the guy and y'all look the same and we were playing football. It's in Chicago. And Spade's like, oh, wait a second. And he pulls his phone out, and we had taken a group photo of all the con guests And Frank pointed to me. He's like, yeah, him. And so it's something about the Spate men cannot differentiate between Richard Spate and Jared Padalecki.
And
I've never,
I've never been so depressed.
That is a question that he never thought he would get asked is, are you surprised people confuse you and Richard Spate?
Excellent, thank you very much.
There you go.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Hi.
Hi,
guys.
Hi.
Hi, guys, my name's Nicole. It's my first convention. I don't really have a question, I just wanted to say something to you guys. Speaking from the absolute bottom of my heart, I was always told growing up that there's no such thing as perfection, but I call bullcrap. I look up on stage right now, and I see my idea of perfect. I don't say this because you're gorgeous, that doesn't matter in the slightest. I say this because you choose to let loose and let your fans see who you really are instead of who you think we want you to be. And I at least see the biggest hearts I've ever seen in anybody I've ever met. I see men who brought an entire extended family together from around the world because that kind of heart is contagious and everyone wants to be a part of it. I see an insane amount of talent. I see fun-loving, goofy men. Sorry, I lost my spot.
Better hurry up.
Who want the world for other people and don't expect anything in return. I can't even begin to tell you how much I love you for helping me become a stronger person and helping me realize who the best person I can be is. Thank you for proving everyone wrong, being who you are, and showing me that I can believe in perfection.
Santies.
Well, I'm going to give her a hug.
That's the only one. No more of that.
Seriously?
I love him.
That was.
Do you realize you just hugged Richard Spate?
Thank you very much. That's
Yeah, same to you. Okay, let's move on, please.
Hi.
Eat that.
Hi, my name is Michelle, and I was just wondering, with the world that we're living in today, what's your one wish for your children?
Where am I? Yeah. So we don't burn the world down.
My hope is that they right a lot of our wrongs. I think each generation gets a little bit better and better, and I'm excited to see what they do with their generation. And I feel strongly that they're going to do things a lot differently than what we've done in the past, and I'm excited for that because I think there's a lot of improvement that we need to make as a race and a society.
That's awesome. My instinct when you ask that is not as macro. I hope for my three children to have overcomable. What's the word for? Where's Lynn? What's achievable? Surmountable. Thank you. I hope for them to have a lot of surmountable struggles. Because that's the only way I ever built self-worth, and you can't give that to somebody, it has to be earned. So I hope they have the struggles. I'm just combining everything. I hope they have struggles, and I hope they are surmountable. Thank you, Atlas. Yeah, so.
My name is Bharti, and I'm from India. This is my first convention, and all my friends from back home send you a lot of love.
Where do you live?
Right now I'm in Toronto.
Okay.
But I moved back like 6 months ago.
From New
Delhi. My question is, how has your perception of God changed in the last 15 years, as Jensen and Jared?
That's a deep question.
Listen, church was earlier today.
For me, how long do you have? To me, God is universal. It's not a Christian God. It's not an Islamic God. It's not a God from Judaism or Hinduism or Buddhism or whatever specific religion or even a pagan God. It's more a universal truth and morality and connection. So if you were Hindu and I was Christian, I hope that I could hug you and give you a kiss on the cheek and love you, you know, and vice versa, without judgment. And that hasn't changed in 15 years. It's kind of been more cemented and solidified. I sort of believe whoever you are, if you're a kind person, then I love you. And human to human, we don't get a lot of time on this planet, you know? So I hope that what little time we do have, we can support each other and love each other and embrace each other and bolster each other's efforts. And yeah, I guess that's been kind of cemented and solidified the last 15 years.
I'll simply say it's over the last 15 years, you know, my God and the spirituality has become more personal and less institutional. So.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Sarah. What I was wondering is, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, when someone says the word supernatural to you, what do you think is going to come to mind?
I mean, I want to preface this by saying, me personally, I don't know about Ackles, but anytime the words super or natural come up in the last 15 years, I'm the annoying guy when someone's like, man, that was a super game. I'll be like, a supernatural game. Or when someone's like, I prefer my clothing and ingredients to be more natural. I'm like, supernatural. I'm really the annoying.
Hey Jared, where are you going to go for lunch? You want to go to Super Salads?
I would like supernatural salads. I've become that guy. So I hope to remain that guy. It's just my
natural instinct.
Is it your supernatural
instinct? Don't say it. My supernatural.
One is enough.
Come on.
What's going to come to mind is it'll be a flood of things. It'll be this vision right here, you know. Seeing you guys, it'll be the smell of the catering tent in the morning. It'll be the high fives that I share with my third AD every morning. It'll be our on-set carpenter coming up and telling me about his weekend. There's a lot of those kind of personal things. That's one of the reasons why I love what I do, and it'll be many of the things that I'll miss about when we're gone. So.
Thank you. Hi.
Hi, my name is Sarah. This is my second con.
I came all by myself today, and I think a lot of the group did too, and I'm wondering what charity or what special cause is next for you both. I think a lot of us have felt really strongly about what you've done in the past, always keep fighting and all the campaigns, and that's definitely what drew me to the show, so I'm wondering what's next.
Very cool. Well, with the help of a lot of you, this past week, we just raised a bunch of money for a food bank in Vancouver and Random Acts that we've raised money for, put in $10,000. And Jensen and Misha and I put in $5,000 apiece, and we got the one day $5,000. Sorry?
We heard why.
You heard why? You heard why? What do you
say? So that you'd win.
Oh, well, there was a bonus. For, long story short.
Yeah, let's be clear why we did it.
To win.
To beat the food missions. Food bank, schmood bank. We wanted to beat the other shows.
We did,
and you know why? Because we're not the lose jesters.
It's the most magical thing you've ever seen.
No, it's not, but this is.
Okay. That is so mean.
He was telling me the score of the a Patriots game. I can't believe it.
Woo!
I can't.
Go Pats!
I'm gonna miss this. This kind of idiocy.
Please bring us back.
Yeah. Hey, I have a question. If we keep doing these after the show's over, are you guys gonna stick with us? It's your fault.
Can you also say money? Son of a bitch for us?
What's the context? What has happened that has made me want to say?
Son of a bitch. God just told you the end is coming.
Son of a bitch. Somebody up here said, baby has a flat tire. That would sound like this. Son of a bitch! I've got about 14 to choose from. It just depends on what the situation is. What's that? Take away pie? God's eliminating pie? Son of a bitch! Yeah, that's number seven.
Do number seven.
Son of a bitch! That's number seven.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, my name's Liz, and I'd like to know what was your first concert, your most recent concert, and who would you most like to see in the future?
What kind of fake accent is that?
UK?
New Jersey?
The UK?
I don't care. Do you care? That was great. That was great. I don't care. Do you care? She said UK. That was great.
It was great.
Terrible.
It was great.
Kmart? It's, yeah, I'm okay. UK? I'm sorry, what was the question?
It was, what was your first concert, your last concert, and who would you most like to see in concert?
Got it. I'll go.
I know all those answers.
Go.
Okay, I will. Quit yelling at me.
Go ahead.
In front of my friends.
Say it.
Okay, my first concert was the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I'm not lying.
You should
I'm
be.
I'm not lying. That was a concert.
Oddly enough, it was put on in his bedroom.
On my life, that was a concert in San Antonio, Texas at the Alamo Dome. Google that. You're welcome. My last concert was Mumford & Sons a week ago today. And the concert I would really love to see... I mean, this is a little awkward. I'd love to see Prince.
It's sad, not awkward.
How about a concert you can see?
Got it.
For the concert,
I have been pretty much. I've seen a lot of people that I would like to see.
He's seen her.
I've seen her. Yeah. And I'm proud of that. Bob Seger, other than me. Ozzy, Bob Seger, or Cardi B?
Yes, Bob. Loud and Swin.
By the way, that Diet Coke is white. I'm suspicious.
Oh, that's because it's tequila. First concert. I'm gonna have to change this, but that's already. It's I know, but it was Michael Jackson. My first concert. Thriller tour. My mom and her sister brought me because they couldn't find a babysitter. And I think I was 6 or 7 years old. And it was at Texas Stadium.
Wow.
Yeah. My second one was Van Halen. But that was the first concert I went to on my own. Like without parental supervision. And my last concert I saw was Robert Plant. And one I'd like to see.
Is it Teddy Ruxpin?
I'm gonna have to go with Spice Girls.
Spice. What would be your Spice Girl name? I know what it is.
Angry Spice.
I was gonna go with Bowleggy Spice.
Yeah, I'm cool with that.
I'll be Foreheady Spice.
Shaggy Spice.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And thanks for the accent impersonation. Are you okay?
Hi, my name is Scott from New York, and not New York City, thanks.
You're welcome.
So this is my first Supernatural convention, will not be my last. But I know you guys do a lot of shenanigans on set. What pranks did you pull for the filming of season 15 so far?
It's hard because it's like it's just a daily barrage of pranks. It's not like any, you know, it's not like a George Clooney prank that takes like 3 weeks to, you know, create. These are like just of the moment. What was the latest one?
We kind of just try and jack around.
So Misha said earlier something about his lower area you were messing with?
That's daily though. That's why none of that like stands out to me.
And that requires precision because it's not a large area. Nice. Nice. Somebody win. Somebody said be nice. Nice to meet you.
Don't be mean.
Yeah, I'm sure that that's a pretty common occurrence. So yeah, I think probably messing with Misha. We are hoping to Phil come. Is he here? Phil?
No.
Oh, damn it. We have somebody who's in town who's been sort of the mastermind behind the gag reels, but he's not here. Yeah, just kind of turn up a good time. You know, it's our last year. We're in episode 8, so we have 11 episodes of Supernatural to shoot until it dies forever.
Why would you say that?
No 16.
Freaking harsh, man.
Be nice.
Start with the gag.
11 episodes left before it burns alive. Into a pile of ash, ne'er to be seen again.
Did you say ne'er? What are you, the bard? Yes, thou hast asked a fine of question. According to Jensen. What was the gag where I think Mark Shepherd was like, he said something, a bunch of it's, and I was like, nice at one. Sorry, I was proud of that one. Thanks, man. Thanks for coming to the convention.
Yeah, we'll try to come up with some elaborate pranks for the last season here.
We'll make it worthwhile.
Yeah, I mean, I'm fairly certain that Misha's not going to make it through the season without a shaved head. You can shave his head, couldn't we? You can hold him down, I can shave his head.
Just
so what
head.
About Jared?
No. You don't touch these lovely locks. What do you think's kept us on the air for 15 years?
Axe body spray.
Hi. How are you?
Hi. I'm Camille. I'm Camille.
Hi, Camille.
I was wondering if you could shout out my friend Isabel over there.
No. Where's Isabel?
What's up, Isabel?
Hi. What's up, girl?
So my question is, basically, you guys have been to so many conventions, and I was wondering, what is something that you've said in a convention or an interview that you now regret saying?
Hey, Camille, how much time do you have? Just kidding.
You're welcome.
What did we say? We said something like, we kind of, I think it was me. A little bit of a, I have a potty mouth sometimes. And so I forget sometimes that not everybody is in their late 30s or above. And I'll say something and then look out and see like a 12-year-old like, so, apologies. What's that? You sign waivers?
Yeah.
Oh, badass.
Yeah, they have to sign waivers now because you're stupid potty mouth.
I feel like I did give some spoiler accidentally.
Yeah, in Rome.
What did I say?
In Gadriel? Rome.
Scooby? I didn't say Scooby Natural.
Yes, in Rome.
Oh, you did.
You said the three of you were doing voices.
That sucks. Yeah. I think, so here's the problem. If I meet somebody on the streets and they're a fan of the show or something, then I can keep pretty tight lips. But here with y'all, I kind of like, yeah, we've been in this together for 15 years, so I'm more likely to share too much. You know, when I read the finale of Supernatural, we're all aliens, and it was all, I shouldn't say that, should I? Just kidding. Where am I? I can't name anything specific other than that I really love Scooby.
You said Jensen, Jared, and you said Misha, Jensen, and I were filming when he had died.
Really?
Yeah. There's Rome. There was alcohol. There was apple juice. There was apple juice.
The good old iPhone. Ackles?
I have no regrets.
Thank you, Camille.
Thanks, Camille.
You're the second Camille I've ever met. My mother-in-law, who's with Jen and my sons right now, is named Camille. She's not old enough to go where they're supposed to go, so she's in Vancouver. She has a gerbil bowl of water and like, yeah. We love like kibble. It has a lot of calories. Nice to meet you, Camille.
Has it a lot of calories?
Hi, how are you?
Hey.
So I know you guys have been asked about characters on
this
death as a whole, but I
want
to know what was the hottest
Sam death
death?
Was the hottest
Sam
artist?
What was the hottest death? Yeah.
What was the hottest Sam death?
Yeah, I'm gonna go Lisa over Julian.
What was your hottest death?
The hardest death scene was, I would, like from a, like a logistical standpoint or from like an emotional standpoint? Logistical standpoint would have been, the season, two. When did the hellhounds rip my chest open? Like I said, three.
You see that to deal with?
That was just so incredibly uncomfortable. And now, like if we were doing that same scene now, it would be a completely different thing. It would be all computer generated. But back then, they did everything practical. So like all of those rips were actually little.
For practical.
Yeah, were literally little threads that were sewn into the shirt and then yanked, and so the shirt would peel back and look like it was being clawed. My costume was all plumbed with blood lines going up my pants and through, and so there was like this huge syringe of blood that was being pouring out of my chest. It was, and it's. It's basically, what is it? High fructose corn syrup. What is it? Corn syrup? It's corn syrup. It's basically sugar. So as soon as it dries. This was Jared's toughest death right here.
I'm just remembering it.
That one sucked. I think that one of the hardest ones though was when Metatron killed Dean, and it was less tough for what I had to do. I mean, it was the "I'm proud of us" speech, but it was hard watching him go through what he was going through. Because I think that's always tough. Like I don't mind doing it myself, but when I have to watch other people like really get emotional and hurt, that's hard for me to watch.
That's funny. My two toughest deaths to go through, and neither were really my death scene, but in season one or two, when I'm on the bed and I'm dead and you're talking to my...
Two, like I said earlier, two.
That scene was hard, man, because I'm trying to pretend to be dead and I can feel him, I can hear him going through what he's going and I can feel him going through what he's going through. What are you saying? I'm a big believer in energy, and so I was laying on a bed trying to hold my breath, and he's sitting there, and I can literally feel Ackles acting his heart out, and I can hear him as well, and I'm basically like tearing up, about trying to be dead. Like,
you did too. You,
I did.
You, yeah, he was laying there dead, and I'm doing the thing, and like my tears are like hitting the sheets on, you know, right next to him, and I look down, and luckily it was the opposite side of camera. So camera was on this side. He was laying in between camera and I, and it was his right eye, like a little. I could see just like a little tear come down.
Oh, yeah.
And I saw that, and I was like, "Okay, it's working."
Yeah. So that was the toughest. It wasn't really a death scene, but I guess I was dead. And then that I'm proud of us scene. I've always hoped that's how the show ends. I don't know how it ends. Necessarily. So, but that to me was like saying goodbye to Sam and Dean. The whole "I'm proud of us" speech. It wasn't necessarily my death scene. It was Apple's, Dean. But that was a really tough, difficult scene to film. Like, I had to kind of like regroup. And I have a great story that I hold onto dearly. And when I was able to shoot a film with one of my idols, and I played a character named Tom. I did a scene, and I cried in the scene, and it kind of took over Jared, you know? And after the scene called cut, my fellow actor, Peter O'Toole, said to me, he brought me aside, he's like, "Jared, stop, those aren't your tears. Those are Tom's tears. Save them." Yeah, and I'll never forget that. And so sometimes you get overtaken, but here I was with this legend and one of my idols, and he just reminded me, like, "Hey, man, we're telling a story. These are your character's tears, and these are for the people that will watch the story. Like, hold on. Like, you're a vessel." Like, I feel like my job as an actor is to be a vessel, you know?
Did you say, "Hey, listen, Pete, Tom's tears are getting me emotional"?
I should have. In hindsight, that was the perfect thing to say, but I didn't say it.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much. To the stage. Amanda, now you know what it feels like to be us. There's so many people out there. You are the last question, so do not mess up. Do not stutter. Do not get it wrong. Do not call me Jensen, because I get really mad. Just kidding. Where are you from?
Maryland.
Okay. That's a happy land, yes?
It's a merry land. I get it.
Amanda, when does a joke turn into a dad joke? When it becomes apparent.
Thank you, good night.
Sorry. I'll stop with the dad jokes.
Please save us.
Please save everybody from my dad jokes.
Now that you've done both Supernatural the Animation and Scooby Natural, how did the two experiences compare?
Ooh,
well-crafted question, Amanda.
That's a great question. You want to start?
Well, I will say the process of doing Scooby Natural was completely different than anything that we've ever done, because we did all of the recording of the voice work a year before the show ever came out, because they record the voices, we do all the dialogue and stuff, and then they animate to what we say.
Yes.
So we're not like following the animation to try to sync it. They animate to what we say. So doing it like that was just so weird because we are already done our work a year before we ever saw anything.
Yeah, and the Japanese animation was already done and animated in Japanese, and so they were trying to write English language
that fit with the mouth
that
movement.
That fit with the mouth movement,
which is a little difficult,
a little strange, a little hairy, which is probably why they haven't done more. Whereas with Scooby, we went in there. It was Ackles and Misha and me, and we just sat there and performed our lines, and they animated to us. Mm-hmm. And we had to go back in and fix a few things, but it was a completely opposite process. Where as opposed to us trying to voice over what's already drawn, we were just saying something and they were drawing to us.
So wildly different. If I had to choose, I would certainly do the Scooby way, because we were free to kind of do what we wanted to do,
and, yeah, 100%.
And that was a lot of fun. And it was the anticipation of 12 months going by was quite the payoff, and we were very excited about it. Everybody, I think, seemed to be pretty excited about that episode. Yeah, that was pretty great. Thank you for your question.
Thank you for your question.
So there's lots to do out there.
Right.
We'll see you in meets and greets. And
yeah, we don't want to scare you.
Lots of graphs.
But because we're suckers for tradition, we're going to sing our goodbye song.
We got one last song for you.
Usually this happens later in the day, but in the spirit of keeping the tradition alive, we're going to sing it now. If you know the song.
This is how we end the convention.
You sing it with us. If you don't know the song, you'll learn it now and you'll sing it next time. Boys, get it?
It's the end of
just the on-stage portion.
It's the time.
song way early. We like it.
Hey, go Patriots.
See you soon.